today, Father Huynh celebrates Mass with us. Something you think about today and during the week. Stan Lee suggests that the person who helps others simply because it should or must be done, and because it is the right thing to do, is indeed, without doubt, a real superhero. Please stand.
Yeah. us always determined to carry out good works. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
The second book of the Kings. Naaman the leper went down and immersed himself 7 times in the Jordan, as Elisha had told him to do. And his flesh became clean once more like the flesh of a little child. Returning to Elisha with his whole escort, he went in and stood before him. "Now I know," he said, "that there is no God in all the earth except in Israel. Now, please accept a present from your servant." But Elisha replied, "As the Lord lives whom I serve, I will accept nothing." Naaman pressed him to accept, but he refused. Then Naaman said, "Since your answer is no, allow your servant to be given as much earth as 2 mules can carry, because your servant will no longer offer holocaust or sacrifice to any god except the Lord." The word of the Lord.
Eternal glory that comes with it. Here is a saying that you can rely on. If we have died with him, we will live with him. If we hold firm, then we shall reign with him. If we disown him, he will disown us. We may be unfaithful, but he is always faithful, for he cannot disown his own self. The word of the Lord.
And they
live quite far away from hometown. Imagine like, you know, you have to travel from Christchurch to the West Coast, and they don't live in the West Coast, but they live in Fantosa, somewhere like that. So it took my friends nearly 4 hours or 5 hours to travel there, because they have to travel on a gravel, you know, on a mountain road. There's no tar seal, and they have to use tractor and travel to see those people. I'm going to show you some pictures and to help you to understand a lot of our lepers is what it looks like. Yeah, you can see in the back here, my friend. His name is Maoha, and he normally do charity and bring the gift for the people. I call him like a bridge, so he connect the people to people. So he bring the sad news to other people and good news to the people who need it. And to be honest, he invited me, but because I couldn't do it, because the flood and also the typhoon, so I couldn't get a chance to be there. I still feel missing. And when I saw the videos he showed, he posted on his Facebook and also some pictures, I felt very pity on, for those people. And this, you can see that this is the, kind of like a tractor or, something normally people in farm use for travel and also carrying thing. And they had to use this one to travel to that place. No car, no truck can get there. And the thing is very slow, only like 10 or 15 kilometers an hour. So it took him nearly 4 hours to get there. And when he get there, a lot of people, like, those people in the picture here, they got leper. And he said that, especially when the weather changed, they feel very sore, very painful. And those people, they're not only painful in their, in their body, but also in their mind too. They got painful in physical and mental, painful too, because the illness, because their appearance, but also people, racist and isolated them too. And of course, the government doesn't do one thing to look after them, so they have to sell look after. And when my friend there, they even though have to bring kind of like a scissors and a hair clipper to give them a haircut too. Some people haven't got a haircut for a long time, and some people even though doesn't know how to eat food that they give, because they never ever see it before. For example, inside normally a bag of food, we have something for the to keep the moisture. And some children, they told it like salt, and they eat them. So therefore, my friend had to tell them, should not eat that one. That one is only for, to keep them moisturized. And he said that, some people, they look at them, you can see their smile, but actually they don't have a fully smile, because inside them, there's always something that have to worry. And he said that it's the pain they suffering is very 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 much. Not like imagine that you only have a cut here, you feel painful already. But for them, they like their body is what eating from from finger to their to their heart. And some of them lost their legs and also their arms, fully arms and legs. Can see that in the picture here, what they have is, I don't think they have enough money to buy a backpack or something like that. So whatever they have, they use it. So the bag here is their backpack or thing to put thing on. And the children, of course, their children affect to their children too. They cannot get out from the village, or they just live there, because when they go out and people knew that they are, they got family members lepers or something, you know, make them feel embarrassed and, you know, shame too. So therefore, they just stay inside in the village and also, you know, happy along that. When they go out, you know, people racist and make them, you know, uncomfortable. So therefore, the children here, they just stay inside and you know, a lot of people, even a lot of children doesn't have enough clothes to wear. You can see that here, a lot of children doesn't have, you know, underneath. And can you see this one? The lady is, I think this one is her red jacket and made of a plastic bag. I think New Zealand, we, you know, we have car, we have red jacket and we have umbrella. And even though, like, you know, when it's raining, we can stay inside and don't have to bother to go out. But over there, still people still have to go out for a living. If they stay at home, nothing to eat. Look at their houses. Look at their ground. You can see that. There's no, you know, concrete or no tassel there, mainly soil. Yes, so what I want to show you that, you know, our Lord didn't isolate his people. He knew that though people had a leper, but he came to them, he healed them, pity on them, and also healed them, and, you know, bring them back to society. So our Lord in the Gospel today invited us to be with our brothers and sisters too. And especially nowadays we have the, you know, they call medicine or something like that to heal the lepers. But we also, you know, if we can be with those people, we don't have to do like a doctor, but we can be with those people, we can pray for them. So make them feel that we journey with them. We be with them like, you know, our Lord, he did. And, you know, my friend said that a lot of society group helping those people at the moment, and also like especially the Catholic nuns and, you know, priests, went there to help them. But, you know, we need more and more people to help those people because they need to understand that. And also they need to see that we care for them and we love them too. We don't isolate them. We don't racist them. So brothers and sisters, you know, I just want to ask you to pray for those people and also pray for ourselves that we are journeying with them and also understand, you know, we are all in one family. May I invite you now to stand up and help us out. I believe in one God,
Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, Son of the unconscious child, was crucified by the Holy Spirit, descended into hell,
Francis, bishops and priests, preserve the church throughout the world. May they receive enlightenment and strength from the Holy Spirit and support from loving communities in their efforts to spread the gospel. We pray to the Lord. For all people, that we learn to live in great harmony with the natural world and develop a great sense of gratitude for Earth's resources which sustain our life. May we leave our world in good condition for future generations. We pray to the Lord. For people whose lives are diminished by poor health, that they retain hope for their well-being, seek and find healing, and live lives of gratitude, generosity, and peace. We pray to the Lord. For the children of Aotearoa, New Zealand, that they have the basic needs of love and belonging, food, education, and shelter, and that they learn to approach life with gratitude and respect. We pray to the Lord. This Respect Life Sunday, we pray for the unborn and elderly, that legal protection keep them from harm, and that we all manifest a deep gratitude for life, even in its most vulnerable forms. We pray to the Lord. For all those who have died recently, especially Don Simpson, Colin Kelleher, Pauline Fitzgerald, that they may rejoice in God's presence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord God, your Christ lives in his church, and we shall see him face to face. When he comes again in glory, help us to show that we hope that he's coming by sharing in his saving word. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Oh,
for your brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, the prayers of your faithful with the sacrificial offerings, that through these acts of devotedness we may pass over the glory of heaven, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
Lift up your heart.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruit of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so, with all the angels, we praise you, as in joyful celebration, we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks, he gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Paul our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray that, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have lived you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Thank you.